Hi, welcome back to PageFly video tutorial series. In this video, I will introduce to you how to make a sticky section on your page with PageFly. Now let's start with us. Here is the PageFly page editor and I have a heading section. Now I will show you how to make it sticky. Step 1, choose this section and navigate to the General tab, scroll down to the Attributes section and then give a unique ID to the element. I will call it Sticky 1 for example. Next, click Add Custom Code icon here and insert this code in custom CSS like this. Please ensure that you got the correct ID after the hashtag sign here. And click Save Change. Done. Now hit Save and Publish buttons to check the page on live view. You can see this section is sticky now. In case you want the sticky section to be at bottom of the page, you just need to move the section from the top and change the code a bit. The ID stays the same. But, here in the Add Custom Code, change top into bottom and save. Now, when you check the page on live view, you can see the section is sticky at the bottom of the page. Similarly, you can apply this way to make a button sticky. Put the button element independently inside a section like this and make this section sticky as I did before. Then click Save and Publish again. You can now check the sticky button on the live page. In addition, you can create a social sticky section by creating a section including social icons and make it sticky. For instance, with this section, I will link the Instagram icon to the Instagram account by using click action function. Lastly, I will make this section sticky. Then save and publish it. As you can see, your customer can go to your social channels by clicking on these icons whenever they want while surfing on your page. In some cases, this sticky feature might not work on some Shopify themes depending on how the theme developer creates the theme. But, we have some useful tips you can bear in mind to fix it. The first situation is when the sticky section doesn't work even after you've followed our guideline above. This might result from the conflict between the above-mentioned code and the theme. To resolve this issue, you will need to open the custom code editor and use this code to make the sticky section visible. You can get the code in the description below. Now, the sticky section works properly. Great! Another situation is when the sticky section unexpectedly overridden by another sticky section. Don't worry. To solve this problem, we just need to adjust the height of the sticky section to fit the height of the theme on the live page. This is the live page. Right-click and choose Inspect option. Next, use this mouse icon to find the height of the sticky section in theme. In this case, it should be 85 pixels. After that, head to the part of the sticky element in PageFly with the name Sticky01 before and adjust the parameter of top. Here, I will edit this top parameter to be 85 pixels. It works on the live page now. But not yet. One last step is that you need to adjust the top parameter in the editor page as well. Just the same as I do now. Okay, I will save this code and save this page. Let's take a quick look again on the live page. It's perfect, isn't it? This is the end of the video. Hopefully you guys understand how to make a sticky section. To learn more about PageFly, feel free to check out our other video tutorials and visit our Help Center. Thanks for watching.